Welcome to Brainstorm, presented by Penn State Hershey Medical Center. Your chance to speak directly with leading brain specialists about the diagnosis and treatment of brain tumors. Now here's your host, Alicia Richards.
Well, good evening to you. Thanks for joining us. Every year, more than 200,000 people in this country are diagnosed with a brain tumor. No one knows what causes them. No one's sure why some people get brain tumors and other people don't. But here are some facts we do know. Brain tumors are the second leading cause of cancer death in men under 30. The fifth leading cause of cancer death in women under 40. Someone can be diagnosed with a brain tumor at any age. Now, during the next 30 minutes, we're going to answer any questions you may have about brain tumors. We've assembled a panel of experts from Penn State Hershey Medical Centers here in our studios. They are willing to talk to you at any time. Let's show you the phone number, guys, just so you know the doctors are sitting in our conference room, actually, right now. We've got about five or six doctors, and the number to call is 346-3333. You can call in not just about brain tumors. These doctors are ready to talk about anything, any brain health issue. I know Alzheimer's is such a huge issue for so many families these days. At this point, let's just talk to our doctor who's here with us today. Dr. Jonas Sheehan is here from Penn State Hershey Medical Center, and we're so glad you guys could partner with us in this effort with us today. Let's talk a little bit about some of the brain issues that you deal with most. Tell us a little bit about that. What is the gist of the work you do at Penn State Hershey?
Most of my work is in the treatment of brain tumors. We also do general neurosurgery and the whole gamut of neurosurgery, spine surgery, peripheral nerve disorders, aneurysms, vascular work, stroke treatment.
Okay, terrific. Well, let's just start with a couple of questions. We had asked viewers to call in, and actually, this we know this is a topic people are so interested in, because as soon as we give the number, the phones really do start ringing. So even if your question doesn't get on the air, you will get it answered by a doctor who will answer the phone in our conference room. But we're also going to be answering questions here on the air. So let's start. Here's some that we've gotten, some from viewers and some that we've compiled on our own. But here's the first question. Having a brain tumor is a really frightening thought. What is it about these tumors that seems more frightening when it comes in the form of a brain tumor than in tumors in other parts of the body? Why is that?
Well, I think our brain is what gives us our humanity and makes us unique. And having something invade that space and potentially rob us of that unique personality and humanity can be very intimidating.
For sure. Look, what are the main signs that, you know, if somebody's having headaches or what might it be, how do you know when it's time to call the doctor? What are the signs of a brain tumor?
Well, the most common symptom associated with brain tumor is headaches, but not many headaches are related to brain tumors. The headaches are very common, only very few are related or are caused by brain tumors. About a third of the time, a seizure, which is an alteration of the electrical activity within the brain, is the first symptom. But usually it's things like weakness or changes in sensation or mentation or mental status changes, confusion, visual changes. It can be basically any neurological alteration.
Gotcha. Do you mind if I fix your microphone? Because I can hear that crackling and we want to hear you clearly.
Sure.
Thanks. I'm going to ask you one more question, then we're going to go to a story. What's the most common way brain tumors are diagnosed? If someone comes in, what happens next?
Well, when there are symptoms that lead someone to be evaluated by their primary doctor, and his history and examination makes him suspicious for a brain tumor, usually there's some sort of imaging study, either a CAT scan or an MRI. There are technical differences between the two, and MRIs are typically better for soft tissue and brain detail. Based on those imaging findings, we usually have a pretty good idea of what sort of tumor we're dealing with. Sometimes a biopsy is necessary, but not always.
Okay, good. We're going to come back with more questions, but first we want to run a story that we've put together here. A diagnosis that you have a brain tumor can be so surprising, obviously, for so many patients. Amanda Martin's here to tell us a full recovery is possible.
Patty Joe and David Hiebschman never saw it coming.
I really had no idea, no clue.
If we were at home,
on a Saturday night in January, Patty Joe and her husband went to see a movie. As her husband tells it, she was unusually quiet on the drive home.
And she basically was very disinterested, very quiet, and I thought really I'd done something quite wrong because I was getting the silent treatment.
When they got home, Patty Joe had trouble recognizing phone numbers, a neighbor's voice. David rushed her to the emergency room thinking it was a stroke.
And one of the residents came to me and said they saw a mass in her head and it was not a stroke, which floored me. I was very, very taken back by that.
I thought, get out. You're kidding. You know, what?
So you see part of the patient's nose, teeth, tongue, back of the head.
The mass at the front of her brain was about the size of a tennis ball. Neurosurgeon Dr. Robert Harbaugh knew he could remove it and suspected it was benign, non-cancerous.
Just hearing the word brain tumor is like being in the ocean and hearing the word shark. You think I'm done for. But one of the important things to understand is more than half of all brain tumors are benign tumors and very curable lesions.
Patty Jo is cured. She says she's had no lasting side effects. In fact, her husband says she was back to her full normal self within days, maybe with one exception.
I think I look at things a lot differently. You know, you come through brain surgery and you don't sweat the small things anymore.
At Penn State Hershey Medical Center, Amanda Martin for ABC 27.
Brainstorm on ABC 27 is presented by Penn State Hershey Medical Center.